Good, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone. This is Complex Chicken Queens Plus. In this case, Plus, actually, it's not the music. It's a demo of part two of the removal and reinstall of the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus case by Lunatic. I'm doing a rotten job already, but anyway. This is the case, and I wanted to show everyone. It was a bit of a trouble getting off. Whoa. Getting the screws out. I was trying to use a size T5. It's actually a T6. And silly me, I find it awkward putting it this long for your case. You know, that's something if you want to reach into a computer case or something. I didn't want to get that elaborate, and this, if you put it right in the end, will go right in the end and disappear. So I did it with my bare hands, and I thought, oh yeah, well maybe you could use this. So, and it works. This is a T6. These cases, I do like them. One of the quibbles I have with it is that keeping your phone ports clean is a big deal. A lot of people, and I could totally see it, their phone ends up not working anymore, not because they've damaged it necessarily or even got it wet inside, because, you know, a long time ago getting it wet was a huge big deal, and now a lot of these ports themselves can handle water, which is quite incredible. But dirt, and especially if it's greasy or oily or any kind of bullshit, can I get this phone to charge and move? Let's see. Use my nose. No. I don't want to gunk with it. This phone, the phone that I'm recording with, is my new one, and it doesn't have a case on right now. It does have a actual screen protector on it. That said, I don't want to break it. I just bought it. Anyway, I just got it in the mail today. Anyways, back to this. This phone actually came with, you know, this peely thing that most people take off their phone right away. I didn't. I decided to leave it on because at the time I didn't have a screen protector and I never end up getting one. It does not protect against being broken, the screen. My son, myself, and I all had a turn, and my partner, my son's father, all had a turn dropping this butterside down, which wasn't a huge deal other than awful. It's, you know, it's not good for the screen. The stupid part mostly was, the bigger stupid part was my getting it wet. Don't do that, folks. If you have a screen that has a, you know, a crack in it even, never mind the whole, you know, like that, don't get it wet. You know, I wouldn't even trust sweat on it or anything because it damaged the sun touch sensor. And so it still works. It hasn't been charged in like a couple months, well, since June, basically. Maybe once before that when I try to get stuff off it. Yeah, don't get it wet. Don't get cracks wet. It's not a good plan. This will still work. I have a dongle for it that plugs into the port so that I can then attach a mouse to it so that I can, it's a computer, basically. I just can't use it directly. So anyways, this is my old screen. My old Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus, and I guess I'm not going to be installing this on the phone that I'm doing right now. I could demonstrate, without putting the screws back in, how this goes in, but what I really want to show everyone is how dirty it gets inside the case, even though and I've done this at least twice, taken it out very gently and cleaned it all, wiped it all, got all the nasty shit out from out of here, it still gets very dirty. Can you imagine how dirty your phone would get if it wasn't in the case? Again, Samsung phones are very good. I imagine this is pretty filthy, even though I did my best to try to keep it clean. Despite not having this part, it came, you can see the little buttons there. It did have a thing that goes pushed into the port and also over the stylus area. Not good. Not good. It didn't take all that long to lose those parts, and that, you know, Lunatic Case Company, that's not cool. You know, part of having a good case is to protect your phone and the ports. The water doesn't seem to be a problem for these phones, but you can't convince me that dirt is good, especially when you're then shoving a, you know, a charge port in there, or charge thing in there. It's not gonna be cool. So, that's not cool. Really not cool. The case itself, it's nice in the hand, except in the winter. It does get cold. This is anodized aluminum. It is very rugged though. I can't say I've had any problems with it protecting the phone. I was a little bit reticent about having this much of it not protected by metal. It hasn't been a problem. I wouldn't want to run over a car and run over it with a car though. Unlike OtterBox, which I really do want to get the OtterBox case. I think I've been having trouble with the OtterBox case company's website. I think that's why I end up with this case, not the OtterBox, because the OtterBox is what I've always traditionally had on all my phones, and iPods, iPod Touch, iPads, stuff like that, always. But I think I just ended up not buying it because the website itself is fucked up, and I'm hoping I'm not running into the same problem, because buying it on eBay is nearly twice as expensive, which not fun. So in the meantime, I'm gonna switch or put this, after I clean it, onto my new phone, and I will show you where I got the other phone case, where I got the phone, this phone. Here you go. Let's see. This is how much I paid for it. That's the shipping and handling. And then I will show you the seller's thing. Here's the seller right there. It arrived, that's when I bought it, and it arrived yesterday. Oh, what's going on here? This phone, I'm so glad not to have this phone anymore. This is the company. So far, I can't say much, I've had it for a few hours, but it's a refurb. So far, it seems to be fine. I'm not going to complain about anything, particularly the packaging it came in was very good. I'm not saying it would have stood up to being crushed or anything, but it was definitely good. It came with, let me see, it came with new, though not Samsung, pretty decent quality from what I can tell. Not the big cube, but not a small cube. I'm not going to say how long it takes to charge it, because this phone actually came charged at about 73%, which is awesome. Here we go. Everybody look at that. And, yep. So, it would be a lie to say that I'm happy that I didn't get an actual Samsung thing, but that is how it was listed. You're not going to get an actual Samsung cable and port. It's a nice OEM, aftermarket, or whatever you call it. I can't say it. It doesn't feel cheap, let's just put it that way. Anyways, yeah, so I will show you briefly how this looks in the case. My old phone, of course. And we'll stick that back in there like that. This phone does not like the cold. Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus does not like the cold. And that might be partially because this metal, it does touch in places. And even if it wasn't touching, it is aluminum, which does not transmit cold much. But it does transmit cold. And I think a lot of that has to do with how... you know, the fact that this phone does not like the cold. Probably if it had a different case, like more of an OtterBox, which is not metal, it is plastic, different kinds of plastic and rubber, it would probably insulate it better than this. You know, I'm now in a place where we routinely get minus 30, minus 40, so that's one of the reasons I want to get an OtterBox. That and I've had such a horrible experience with a broken screen being damaged and the shit I had to go through not having a proper phone, such as this one, which is, look, it got a crack too. I'm not normally that bad with phones. This is the one I bought for like $230 or something. You get what you pay for, folks. So basic. And the biggest fault is the battery. The battery died. It went to 2%. I know I'm probably repeating myself a million times, but this is how annoyed I am by it. I happen to say, though, I do love the little old phone jack, but the battery, it died. I got it new, not refurbed, but new, back in June, and it died a month ago. And it basically went to 2%, which is not uncommon for me. I plugged it in after I took off the Wi-Fi and the data, turned those off so it would charge quicker. I left it for an hour, over an hour I think, came back and it was still at 2%. I'm like, oh dear. And I'm, you know, I'm like, yeah, it's charging. It's actually charging. It didn't like get weak, you know, the port was properly pushed in and it was charging. It just didn't charge. So I was like, well, I still have to use it. I used it for, I don't know, a couple minutes, and then it went to zero, and then it turned off, and then no matter what I do, it won't turn on. I'm very annoyed because I have extremely important information on this phone, and I have no idea how to get it off. You know, do you take the phone apart? I'm into do it yourself. I miss the times when, you know, you could open up a phone and replace the battery yourself. This, I don't know. I'm kind of living in the middle of nowhere now, so that's going to be something I have to figure out. So anyway, this is what the lunatic case looks like on the phone, Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus. I'm not going to put the screws back in, obviously, because it's not the case, the phone I want in it. It will do for now. I will still try to get the OtterBox, a lot of it to do with the ports. The port covers, they make a big deal on the OtterBox about getting it right and not making these easily to be falling out. I'm going to be doing a lot of dirty, nasty, messy things, and I don't want dirty, nasty, messy, you know, charge ports and stuff like that. This is not going to be protecting it the way I want. Also, the OtterBox case comes with the clip, which I don't want to use the clip because to me that is like too easy to pop off, but it still acts as a second screen protector. And also because it's all rubber and plastic as opposed to metal and plastic, it's going to be not so hard on my battery. This battery, by the way, actually is pretty damn good considering how much I've used it up until the point where it became, you know, a big computer, basically, where you have to use a mouse. I'm not saying it was great by the time I had to say goodbye for a while, but it's definitely very good, and this, oh my god. Like, I bought this January 1st, 2019? Was that the year of the lockdowns? Because we had the lockdown starting in March. I bought this January 1st. And the battery still works. And I used it more than this because this does not have the features this does. And this was so much more frustrating than this. So I ended up, you know, just not being able to do most of the stuff I wanted to do. And the battery died on this in what, June to a month ago. Basically it died, when did it die? October 30th-ish, 29th, 30th. Yeah, not fun. I've been using this one, which is my aunt's phone, since then, and this one came in the mail yesterday, and I got to it today. So yeah, piece of shit phone. You get what you pay for if you are, you know, don't have a lot to spend, or you think you're only going to be using it for a little while before you get a new phone. Maybe okay, because it was $235 or whatever cash. But my god, the battery dying, fuck you. Because I don't know how to get my information off it. So that's kind of a rant that I'm, you know, probably gonna hear a lot of if I'm doing anything electronic wise, phone wise, because this just pissed me off so bad. This, I'm not sure what it is. I think it's an A I could close it off. I don't feel like it. That's a whole other conversation. So anyways, if you like what you see, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell, share. This is a decent case. I might have mentioned in a different video, the sound that escapes this is good. I think it makes it a little bit more directional sounding. It doesn't seem to impede the sound, and the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus is a very good phone for sound quality without a microphone even, or sorry, without using headphones. The sound is very good. The tones are very good. This phone was painful to listen to. So was this. Like, literally tone, like, sound volume and, like, some of it was sharp and painful. This, they've got it right. You can have it loud and it's not painful. Like, you know, I don't know. You'd have to be an audiophobe or audiophile to be able to explain things. But very good. Very good phone. Again, don't know about its counterpart in the Apple world because I didn't buy an Apple, and I was disgusted by the kind of politicking that was going on with the Apple company. They also didn't have the Apple the touchscreen from the 6S Plus, which I had before, and I loved the 6S Plus. The only reason I got a new one is because it was getting old. The battery was getting pretty ridiculously worn down, and you know, it's time for an upgrade, so I did. And the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus has a lot of good features. You can get it again, you can get it on eBay. I gave you the seller, seems like a good price so far. The phone's great. Anyway, I hope you have a wonderful morning, afternoon, evening, and night, whenever, wherever, and whomever you are. Stay awesome, stay adventurous, and YouTube, please don't be a dick and, like, copyright strike the music. I've already showed you, you know, here we go. And this one, I hate this phone so bad. It just, oh my god. But anyways, I did show everybody. Oh, come on. Ridiculous phone. I mean, I've actually fucked things up because it's so slow to respond. See what I mean? Junk. Oh, that's the kind it is. There you go. Not a fun phone. Oh my god. So you can see why I get frustrated with this phone, because it's like, hi, I'm not even gonna respond now. Anyways, hope you have a lovely morning, afternoon, evening, and night, whenever, wherever, and whomever you are. Stay awesome, stay adventurous. Stay strong. Bye. Booyah!